Leika, you are safe, blessed. Ozo,
Jesus!
You have been a victim.
Yeah.
You have 10 seconds to leave the Big Brother house.
You remember the thing I told you? There you go. What's going to happen in my life?
9, 8, 7.
Now, person, wait patience. 9 days wait to see say Agbalumo they turn chingon last. In case you don't know what Agbalumo means, Agbalumo is a fruit in Nigeria. It is also called Odara. You can Google it. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, you're most definitely welcome. If you're a regular viewer, thank you so much for always coming back to watch my videos. Guys, it is not news that Tricky T and Ozo has been evicted from the show, but the shocker for me tonight was Ozo's eviction. Ebuka is the master of suspense. I'm not even going to lie. If you see what Ebuka did, he raised my hat and put it in my mouth, and then removed it from my mouth, put it on the ground and crushed it. At the point where Ebuka said, Leko, you not close his eye. You are safe. I say, guy, how far? At this point, people are thinking that, why is this vote going to be like? Guys, did you see the vote? The vote was mad. Lekon dust everybody. As a tricky to just weak me, I just see 4%. I say, What I was saying is that if Namibi be tricky to family members, I wouldn't just waste my time to vote, because at the end of the day, we know that the people standing, they are very serious people. So for me to go and be voting, I use all my millions to vote, and at the end of the day, he was still good, and let's not bother. No offense, sincerely, no offense to Tricky T, but then his vote was 4%. Guys, Dorothy's own shocked me. Dorothy dust Ozo, as in dust them. Let me tell you what happened. So the eviction show started out with, of course, Ebuka doing flashback, reminisce here and there, but he came into the house and he asked some questions. You guys know these question things. I used to break tables and shake tables. The first person he asked question was Nengi. Oh, what's up with you and Ozo? I don't know, people have been going back and forth about this. What is Ozo to you right now? She said he's my best friend. Ebuka close one eye, look, I say, okay, let's move on from that. He now went ahead to ask Neo, how far? You were advising Ozo about Nengi that I should lock up, so what do you have to say? He said, Ozo not my guy normally. So the normal thing where V don't tell me normally before, and I say, guy, allow me make I miss you small. So anything will happen, sometimes just give me my space. Then when I miss you, I know say the things will still work out again. And at the same time, he just try to tell Ozo, say, Ozo, he dey try well for the baby. Everybody they see and say, he dey show, say you care, you do. Never say she no care, she dey show. But then that space where you could just give her small, make she miss you. Now the thing when I try to tell her, may lock up, now my day one guy, I will consult a lookout for her. Ebuka now went ahead to ask him, okay, do you think that Ozo is doing too much for Nengi, like the love is too much? He now said no, that he's not even going to say it's too much, because he too is that kind of person. Now nothing is too much. The guy loves the babe and is showing her the kind of love and the care that he has for her. And that's what's up. As in, I commended Neo for answering this question like this. I say, if not me, I swear to God I for lose guard. If they say he's also doing too much, I for just do, I feel he's doing a little too much. That is what is going to come out from my mouth. But for Neo to be able to answer this question that no, I don't think he's doing too much, I feel like he loves the babe. Neo, you too much. This answer, it is the answer. It's not being diplomatic. He's just being true and he's being real. He does not have the right to tell anybody that anybody is loving anybody too much. Now what he wants and now what he do. Anyways, after this whole thing, Ebuka now came back to ask V how she felt about she and Neo being safe. Now, did she think that she won the battle? Of course, skimmed the people, and then she had a hand in making them choose the people that they chose. She explained that no, she doesn't think so. Then I asked also if he feels happy about this choice. Say he just felt like he was a team player, even though at some point they were arguing. He now moved on to the next thing. Then now, of course, evicted Trickity. When Trickity came out, Trickity was not talking about his journey, and I talked about Ozo and how he, even though like he had a relationship outside the house, that would he have followed anybody in the house, because there was a thing with him and Watoni. He now said, that he likes Watoni, he's not even going to lie. From the first day when he saw her, it was like, this babe, you're not Nigerian, you know, but he liked her. But then again, even if he liked her, he's not going to do anything with her in the house. He's not Ozo, so he's not going to do anything in the house. So he will just wait for him to come outside and see how things is going to work. People are different, and that's it for him. They now asked him, what's up, what's his next step, what's he going to do? He now said that he wants to do filmmaking and music. And I moved on to Ozo. When Ozo got evicted, as in, I felt so bad for Nengi. Like, you could see that she was hot, but she deformed hard girl at the end of the day. I don't know what was going on there. Nengi held his face as if she wanted to kill him. That's how Ozo said, well, not bring him here, as if she wanted to kill him. That's how the girl just turned there, shifted small, say, baby, nothing like that. You know, if you work for you. But it was emotional. When he left, she started crying. He hugged everybody. He was not telling you, take care of Nengi for me. Nengi, take care of yourself. Remember what I told you. As though they've already prepared and planned for his exit, even though it was obvious that he hurt Nengi. But the one I don't understand is, now that he has gone, she has cried small, and now she's moving on with her life. She don't go change to her bikini. Like I said, they want to do some jacuzzi thing, because at the end of the day, Big Brother gave them cakes and wines, gave them glasses. And what they did was that they did a cheers to all the housemates that have been evicted. They now popped this champagne, as in it was mad. The jacuzzi is running, music is playing, so they are preparing for their jacuzzi. Another thing I want to establish in this video is the fact that Ozo, when he was exiting, he said he wanted to give a speech, and he gave a speech to his mom, his dad, his sisters, and of course his well-wishers and everybody. And then let me say something about the way Ozo answered his questions. When Ebuka called him out, before Ebuka was even going to start bringing up the whole Nengi thing, I was waiting for Ebuka to ask him those kind of questions that would just enter him, like, what's up with you and Nengi? But before he even asked him, only also don't use your own mouth, they just say, I know that people are going to call me a dumb bomb. Ebuka now said, why do you think that people will call you a dumb bomb? He said, because I feel like the way I was showing the love and care that I have for Nengi, people are going to think that, oh, this guy doesn't know what he's doing, but I know exactly what I'm doing. At the end of the day, I came here for a reality TV show and not a love show, but love came in and then I decided to follow through. So I feel like people will be saying that, oh, this love thing, this love guy, and but it doesn't matter. He has shown it. At the end of the day, he came to show his personality, and that is what he did. Then Ebuka now went ahead to ask him that, how come you were still persistent on this Nengi's matter, even though she told you that she had a situation outside? He said the thing that drew him to Nengi is her drive, the fact that she has been through a lot, he heard her story, and of course she is physically attractive. And of course, that one of the things that Nengi said to him, though he's not trying to compare Nengi to his mom, but one of the things that Nengi said to him is that some guys are drawn to people like their mom, that Nengi is a smart girl, she's intelligent, that the way she does her things, that even the housemate, she commands respect. When she's head of house, you will see the respect that she commands, and that's some of the qualities that he sees in her, and that is why he will not stop, he will continue to go for her, that he's somebody that doesn't give up. So is Nengi. So yes, that was why he did all the things he did, and he will not stop showing it. Mr. Golov, even in his eviction, even in his downtime, he still they preach love to Nengi. At some point, I saw that the internet was shaking, that, oh, why did Ozo go? Some people were even crying. I said, maybe when they say make the boy go, I feel like the reason why this boy left today is because God now know what thing they see for forms. Because at the end of the day, maybe if Okongwu gets strike, the cow, the 4.30 million, everything for go, we don't know. As it don't happen like this, we could take him in good faith. And at the end of the day too, anybody who's supposed to win the show go win him. Even though I'm seeing some fishy things going on around the internet, I'm seeing that a lot of people are supporting Lekomo. First of all, his vote is of course a very prominent factor, but I know how these things are. People that were not supporting him because they've already seen that this guy looks like he's going to win, it's just a shout, Lekomo icons. How come now today they hear Lekomo icons? One already they support and since from day one. The true fans of Lekomo know themselves. That's what I'm going to say. Anyways, you are welcome to join the team if you want to join. No, we're going to pursue people, fans of them. So if you want to vote for Lekomo, please go ahead and vote for Lekomo. But looking at the thing already, we don't know. This show is a shocker, like us that we're predicting and doing ultimate veto power. That's why they shock us. So there was no ultimate veto power anywhere, nothing happened. The also don't go house, the veto power, no veto. So guys, let us talk in the comment section as usual. So I'm going to end this video here. Until next time, I'm going to see you on my next one. Bye guys.